All right. Hi, everyone. Thanks for joining us today. I'm Shane Huddleston, Product Manager at OCLC. I'm joined by my colleague, Dave Collins, a Principal Software Engineer at OCLC, and we're going to talk about rendering images from PDFs. So first off, a little about OCLC and CONTENTdm. OCLC is a nonprofit global library cooperative. We provide shared technology services, original research relevant to libraries and archives and community programs. CONTENTdm is our digital collection management service. There are over 1,400 separate instances of CONTENTdm globally, served from our four data centers, USA, Canada, Australia, and the Netherlands. We have support for IIIF presentation and image APIs today, but before adopting Cantaloupe, that support was limited to images, only to image records. We wanted to broaden this to support PDFs, but when we took a look, our image server was old. It had some inherent limitations. Of course, compliance with IIIF is a must-have for any of our updated functionality in CONTENTdm. So we took a look and surveyed image servers used in the IIIF community. We found a lot of really good information and advice searching through the discussions in the IIIF Slack channels and past presentations like this one at conferences. So we settled on Cantaloupe. Cantaloupe is an image server, handles generation of image tiles and zoom levels from high resolution originals. That's what we needed. And for us, Cantaloupe was the best technology match. It's implemented in Java. We're mostly a Java shop. It works well in a multi-tenant environment, and it has robust support for JPEG 2000. In CONTENTdm, we store all image derivatives as JPEG 2000 files. Of course, Cantaloupe has built-in support for IIIF Image API and includes both versions 2 and 3. We did do some evaluation of OpenJPEG implementations in Cantaloupe, but we found there were some performance problems and memory management issues that were solved by Kakadu. So that's a licensed extension, if you will, to Cantaloupe. We have noticed that there have been some recent improvements to OpenJPEG that we're keeping our eye on, but so far we're pretty happy with Kakadu. And as we were implementing this, we needed to create a database to support the integration with Cantaloupe. And that was a really good opportunity for us to switch up the way we were building IIIF presentation manifests. We had been storing them, creating them statically. We had millions of presentation manifests on disk, and that had some obvious problems, updating them, keeping them fresh, and all of that. So we made the decision to switch to doing dynamic generation of presentation manifests. I did want to call out that we incorporated a Java library built by the MDZ Digital Library team at the Bavarian State Library. That was super useful. And I'm going to turn it over to Dave to talk about some of the finer details of what this implementation looked like.
Great. Thanks, Shane. Okay, so for those of you who have not heard of Apache PDF Box, it is an open source library written completely in Java. There are benefits and drawbacks to this. One benefit is that the execution is limited to the Java virtual machine, the Java virtual machine process, both memory and CPU usage. So what that means is we can better control the memory consumption rather than having random processes consuming memory outside of the JVM. The downside of this is that the performance of the library is not as good as, say, a library that is using a native process on the machine. The way that Apache PDF Box does this in Cantaloupe, PDF is a vector format, as you well know. Cantaloupe has to convert that PDF page from the vector format into a raster or pixelated form image and use the Java 2D pipeline to transform it. So you see something like this, where you have these nice lines and fonts as well. You'll see in a PDF that the lines are nice and smooth, but a pixelated version, you can see some of the pixels. Another nice thing about PDF Box is that if libjpeg turbo is available on the system, it'll use that for writing the JPEGs out to the buffer, other than the Java image IO library, which is not as performant and a little bit dated. libjpeg turbo has continuous development on that. So how many PDFs are we talking about in ContentDM? Was it really that big a deal to have just image support and not PDF support? Wouldn't our users just be happy enough with the image support? So that led us to do some research. In total, combined, we have 37 million individual PDF pages and 38 million JPEG 2000 image derivatives. So nearly 50% of all the content that we were serving up between those two is PDF. Many of the PDFs are a single image on a PDF page that's used for OCR transcription and overlay. And there are various reasons that people want to use that. So it became a necessity that we support PDF. So when we initially started using Cantaloupe, we faced some challenges. Cantaloupe's implementation on how to access a PDF page was flawed. What would happen is you would access it by a query string parameter, say ?, page equals 15. That does not match the IIIF URI specifications. It was kind of a one-off workaround to get PDF support into Cantaloupe. And it does not work in Mirador. What you would see is that the resulting display would be in Mirador would be the first page on every image. You can see down below here, ignore the two, but every single page would be the first image of that PDF in Mirador and other IIIF viewers. So what was the solution that we worked on? We went to the Cantaloupe team and started discussing alternatives. What we suggested that we do is incorporate the page number as a subdelimiter of the identifier in the IIIF URI. This is a common practice for uniform resource names. It's something that we wanted to match a standard. Semicolon was an ideal solution for us. In Cantaloupe, you can decide what kind of delimiter you want. So if you have semicolons in your identifiers already, you can define to use some other identifier. So you went from something like this, where you had the ?, page equals 15, to this, where you have semicolon 15. The benefit of that is now, this is a standard IIIF URI, and it works in Mirador. You have all of the images. So a blessing and a curse of having these 37 million different PDF pages. It's a huge amount of diverse, very diverse data. And we encounter it, day to day, something new every day. As you can imagine, people who create PDFs do it in many different ways. We have customers that do optimized compression on their images in the PDF. We have customers that have born digital. We have customers that don't optimize the images in the PDF. So we have to be prepared for all of that. How about 2 gigabytes? The biggest PDF that we found was 2 gigabytes in our system. And I don't want to embellish too much. That was the largest. Our average size is 13 megabytes or so, which is more reasonable. But the extreme end of the bell curve we found some users that had very large PDFs. So what? So what does this mean? Well, this was another challenge that we had with Cantaloupe out of the box. So the way that PDF box works is it loads the entire PDF into memory, retrieves the page, and renders that page as your raster image. So if you wanted to create a PDF manifest, like we did a presentation manifest with PDFs, and load that in Mirador, each single page would be loaded into memory each time. So 10 megabytes plus 10 megabytes plus 10 megabytes plus 10 megabytes. Obviously, you can see where this is going. Now, let's pretend that a professor is teaching his class and he sends out this link to his students of, you know, 30, 40 students in his class and says, hey, I want you to open this Mirador presentation. So now we've got a exponential growth. And if we go back to that 2 gigabyte example, well, it becomes untenable. So once again, we approach the Cantaloupe team and we worked with them on implementing a feature of Apache PDF box that allows you to allocate file storage instead of memory for the rendering portion. So OCLC uses this to restrict the amount of memory each PDF uses and then rolls the rest over into a scratch file. That scratch file is then, you know, you're only limited to the amount of file space that you have when you're rendering these PDFs. Granted, it's slower. That's a trade-off for having this, but it was a great solution. And this is this feature is now generally available in Cantaloupe 5.0. All right, so there are caveats, of course. We know that PDF boxes still are bottleneck. We are continuing to investigate ways to squeeze better performance out of Apache PDF box. There are other libraries that might be used. Maybe switching over to a native implementation is better. So we're investigating all avenues, but for now we're moving ahead with PDF box with the knowledge that we have to probably look for some better performance out of it. PDFs are weird. If you plan on doing this, you can control the way a PDF is compiled, but there's not really any rules on what you can put in a PDF or how you put it in a PDF. And when Apache PDF box reaches some of these weird PDFs and tries to load them in, you can imagine you can embed video or audio into a PDF. And how does Apache PDF box handle this? So we've run into a lot of that with our diverse set of PDF pages. We are continually tweaking things here and there to be able to render these into IIIF. But I wanted to point out that be prepared for weird things to happen with PDFs. Also, if you plan on doing this, scaling is a necessity. OCLC is fortunate to have our own data centers in all the regions. But if you're going to do this and you don't have a data center and you decide to do this in AWS, you have to configure for auto scaling. You're going to run into CPU and memory issues, especially with the larger PDFs. Those are the caveats that we've run into and that I wanted to make aware to you. So I will send it now back over to Shane.
Cool. Thanks, Dave. So where are we at in this project? We've gotten about 60% of the way through installing Cantaloupe to all ContentDM sites. There is a lot of data preparation that needs to happen before we can switch sites over. We're in some cases doing some file conversions, preloading information about images and the items in general into a Postgres database. It takes quite a while when you have tens of millions of items. And then of course, I mean, Dave talked about some of this, but we've found issues, bugs along the way, data specific problems that we've had to fix those and sort of stop the process until we can get that cleaned up. We do think we'll be done with this in probably another month, maybe two, depending how this last 40% goes. For this initial launch, we are still only supporting version 2 of the core image and presentation APIs. But we did, since we were redoing the presentation manifest to make them dynamic, we did structure our URL patterns so that we can be ready to drop in version 3 at a future date. And lastly, for practical server load reasons, we did end up limiting the PDF size. So there is a cutoff, which is configurable. If the PDF is too huge, it's not going to be available through IIIF Image API yet. So that's something we're going to keep looking at and see what we can, how far we can push that. So this screenshot shows a CONTENTdm item page from the Boston Symphony Orchestra archives. We've heard several times at this conference and just in general that the IIIF community talks a lot, maybe a little too much, about technical implementations and APIs and whatnot. Dave and I are fulfilling that prophecy today. I think all of us know, you know, that third eye for interoperability in IIIF means that we automatically had support for these PDFs in the wide range of viewers and systems that IIIF kind of revolves around. So we already have methods to integrate Mirador 2 and Mirador 3 into CONTENTdm. So, you know, anybody who is already using those, these PDFs will just work. They'll just start working through those viewers. But since PDFs are typically some kind of document or bound volume, we also wanted to provide a more native book viewer page flip interface approach. So we adapted the Internet Archive's book reader, open source viewer, as a recipe in the CONTENTdm cookbook framework. And the arrow on the side shows an icon there, a little book reader icon. And when you click that, the IA book reader loads the item. So it's using IIIF to load directly into the book reader. The status screenshot doesn't really capture a whole lot of the joy of a page flip viewer, but I think Dave is going to drop the link in and you can check it out. It's pretty cool. And I think, as we all know as well, UI is powerful. So being able to see this in action is the whole point. That's why we do this. And lastly, just a little bit on where we're heading next. So once we finish installing Cantaloupe and things are stable, there are things that we want to improve. So as I mentioned, IIIF version 3 support, that hasn't really been something that our users have been pushing us on. So we haven't actually prioritized that yet, but we did lay the groundwork to do that. So implementing version 3 is going to be much easier in the future. We also do want to support search term highlighting in IIIF viewers. We're going to look at that as we evaluate CONTENTdm's OCR functionality. That's something that's happening in the coming months. And then we mentioned these pathologically large PDFs. At some point, you're never going to render them dynamically, not possible. So we're looking at possibly creating pre-rendered static images on disk in those cases. That might end up being the only way to really perform well enough for those cases. All of this work is driven primarily by what we are hearing from our users. So we'll be listening to that feedback as we roll out and kind of publicize Cantaloupe and the availability of PDFs through the IIIF Image API. And I think we don't necessarily have a lot of time for questions, do we?
No, I'm afraid we're just at time, but feel free to take the conversation on to Hoover to ask the questions. I've got one question, so I will ask that on Hoover, but I'm afraid I have to call it at an end here. But thank you both. That was a really, really interesting presentation. So thank you.
Thanks, everyone.